Good job, Lauren.
Okay, I got it. Dad!
Okay, don't forget to carry the one.
Dad.
Okay.
That was delicious. Thank you. All right, hold on there, kiddo.
Dad.
Say cheese.
Cheese.
There you go. Okay, just one more. Hold your trophy up a little bit higher.
Dad.
Good morning, good morning, good morning.
It's time to rise and shine.
Dad.
I love it.
No.
Dad. Dad.
And they were here first.
Dad.
So you want to go catch a movie at like 7:30 or something?
Dad.
And one more. Okay, one more.
Okay, let's go.
Wait, come on, just one more, one more.
Dad.
I'm so proud of you. Now you just gotta get a job.
Dad!
You look beautiful.
Oh, Dad.
And stand just a little closer together and move just a little bit to the left. My left. A little more.
Dad!
Of what they think you're like, but I've heard the tender whisper of love in the dead of night, and you tell me that you're pleased and that I'm never alone. You're a good, good father. It's who you are, it's who you are, and I'm loved by you. It's who I am, it's who I am, it's who I am. Oh, and I've seen many searching for answers far and wide. Deeper still as you call.
my Father's world, and to my listening ears, all nature sings and round me rings the music of the spheres. This is my Father's world. My Father's world, the birds their carols raise, the morning light, the lily white, declare the Maker's praise. This is my Father's world.
My name is Melissa Goodwin, Chair of the Staff Parish Relations Committee here at Wyandotte First United Methodist Church. I appreciate everyone's help and cooperation as we've been saying goodbye to Pastor Diana. We all have a memory that stands out to us during Diana's time here, whether it was a wedding, a baptism, a funeral, a confirmation. Gosh, that list could go on and on. Today you will see Diana's goodbye message and you will see our tribute to her time in the ministry as we look back over her years of service.
I come to you today to say my farewell. Never in a million years could I have ever imagined that I would be having to talk to you via video to say goodbye. We've been through a lot together. The world has changed in so many ways. Together we have seen Ebola, Zika, and now the coronavirus. We have seen tsunamis and hurricanes that cause major destruction in many parts of the world. We have seen hundreds of terrorist attacks, domestic and foreign. Our youth have grown in these 7 years. I've been part of 3 confirmation classes, 3 youth mission trips to Tennessee, numerous graduation celebrations, high school and college. I have seen our little bell ringers turn into chime players. Our cherub choir became the discovery choir. We have celebrated as new life was born into our church family. We have celebrated the love and commitment between two people as we witness marriages. We have had great losses to our church family. We have cried together as we celebrated the lives of many of our loved ones who went on to the church triumphant. I want to thank each and every one of you for your support over these past 7 years. Your love and kindness has been so appreciated. I will never forget you. You will always have a place in my heart forever. But now it's time for me to move on to the next chapter in my life. Thank you for being a major part of the chapter that is now closing. I look forward to hearing the progress you are making as a congregation that is making disciples who make disciples under the guidance of a gifted pastor, the Reverend Mark Miller. And now I want to close for the last time. Until we meet again, may the Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord lift his countenance upon you and give you peace. And may the blessing of God Almighty, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit be with you now and forever.
Thank you. Hello, Diana. This is Dave and Beverly, in case you don't recognize us under our masks. But, we're both really, really sorry to see you go, and we think you've been a great pastor. The best one we've had so far. And we're going to miss you, and we hope everything goes well with you and your family, and you'll still be in my prayers. And good luck to you in everything you do. God bless you and your family.
Hi, Diana. It's the Bye. Goodwin family. And of course, you've been with us through a lot in your time here, and we are thankful for you and your family, for all of our times with the kids at Mountaintop and with confirmations and Tyler at annual conference, and when we had the biggest grief moment of our lives, you were there. And we appreciate everything about you. And you have taught me that a woman can lead in a church and do things in ministry. I didn't know women could do that before you.
Diana, I'm just so happy that you get this opportunity to have a new chapter in your life and that you're going to be retiring. But before you go, I just know that there's three things that I kind of wanted to touch on. One, I am extremely grateful for you being here for our good times as well as my personal bad times. I said I wasn't going to cry, but that's not going to work. And so, second, I wanted to tell you that at the SPRC meetings, I was extremely touched by the fact that often you did not speak for a great amount of time, but the things you said were so insightful because you listened very carefully. And third, your family has been such a blessing to me. I'm going to miss Ariana and Giovanni so much. Or actually, Gio. And I loved working with Missy in Sunday school, and I really got to know Michelle and really loved her family as well. Just have a great time, but thank you so much.
Well, Reverend, it was a pleasure being here with you at the helm. Somewhere around junior high school, I gave up on organized religion, calling myself a Christian, because of just what was going on in my life and in the church I used to be part of. But this building and the people in it have been good to my family, and it was a pleasure being here while you were at the helm. Good luck out there.
Pastor Diana, Grayson Grenz here from Trinity Lutheran Church down the road. It has been a joy to work with you the last few years here in Wyandotte on the Wyandotte Ministerial Association. And as you head off into retirement, which I'm sure is not so much retirement as it is a different focus of ministry, something different to still continue to serve our Savior, I wish you the best and pray for you. Success and enjoyment, but also a wonderful and incredible time as you spend more time with family and friends. Blessings to you, and don't be a stranger. Please come back to Wyandotte. Let's do lunch. Blessings to you. Bye-bye.
Hello. My name is Amy Treblosser, and I'm the pastor at Flat Rock First United Methodist Church. I'm very honored to be with you today as we celebrate the ministry of Pastor Diana. Pastor Diana is an extraordinary Christian, clergy, mentor, and friend. And I know as she moves on into her retirement that she will continue to be in ministry, bringing those around her closer and closer to the kingdom of God. Because that's just who she is, and that's just what she does. I was very blessed to have Pastor Diana as my clergy mentor during my time in seminary. And during our weekly meetings, I came to greatly appreciate her genuine faith in Jesus Christ, the steadfast love that she had for all the people that God put in her charge, her relentless work ethic on behalf of the church, and her hilarious sense of humor and ability to laugh in all circumstances. Pastor Diana is one of those extraordinary people who takes the time to listen, to pray, to care, and then to take action. The Holy Spirit flows in her, directing her as she guides others towards true holiness. one scripture that just kept coming to my mind when I was trying to think of how best to describe Pastor Diana is Romans 12, 2, 1 and 2. The Message version is entitled, Place Your Life Before God, and says, so here's what I want you to do, God helping you. Take your everyday, ordinary life, your sleeping, eating, going to work, and walking around life, and place it before God as an offering. Embracing what God does for you is the best thing that you can do for God. Don't become so well adjusted to your culture that you fit into it without even thinking. Instead, fix your attention on God. You'll be changed from the inside out. Readily recognize what God wants from you and quickly respond to it, unlike the culture around you, always dragging you down to its level of immaturity. God brings the best out of you, develops well-formed maturity in you. This is what Pastor Diana has done throughout her years of ministry. She has given her entire self, her entire life over to God every single day in everything that she has done. Pastor Diana focuses on Jesus Christ and not the world around her. And her beauty shines from deep within, from the inside out, as she seeks to follow the will of God by following the direction of the Holy Spirit. And I have no doubt that she will continue to do so as she moves on into retirement. So, my beloved friend and colleague Diana, go with our blessings. May you sense God's presence with you as you start this next phase of your journey. May you recognize all the love that you gave during your years of service and feel all that love in return to sustain you in the days ahead. May God's peace flood through you as you remember all that you accomplished in the name of Jesus Christ. And may you welcome whatever work God calls you to next. After some rest, of course. Blessings, peace, and love, Pastor Diana. Wherever your retirement takes you, please know that you are taking pieces of our hearts with you as well. We are all better for having known you and been pastored by you. Thank you so much for letting me be a part of this celebration. And do know that I will continue to pray for you, Wyandotte First, as you go forward into what God has planned for you next as well. Blessings and peace.
Thank you for joining us today. As we continue this transition, let us pray together. Bow our heads. Dear Heavenly Father, in these days of uncertainty, be present in our hearts and souls. In these days of anticipation, be present in our mind and spirit. In these days of change, be present in our time and space. Grant us your deep peace. In your Son's name we pray. Amen.